What's up, guys? Sammy D here. And yeah, today I made a few changes to while I was off stuff, I made a few changes to the base. I added a second furnace. I'm not sure if we did that, but I moved our bed up here. I labeled all these. I did a lot of mining. I'll show you what I got in a minute, but I got some iron chests. And a bunch more chests. So here, it's just a bunch of ores. I made some seared bricks for something we're gonna do today, and those are just from four of these. And you get make these from. Oh wait, wrong block. But I hit U instead of R. It's okay. It's just gonna take a minute. Any minute now. It's just from grout. If you smelt grout, furnace, you get one. And this is made from sand, clay, and gravel, so did a lot of digging. And then here's my agriculture chest. Nothing much. And in here, see, I did a lot of mining. I found 29 diamonds, 3 emeralds, some redstone, gold. I found more iron, but I'm gonna use it today. I got more force gems, some sapphires, lapis, all the good stuff. It's there. Yeah. So today I want to start to go into Tinker's Construct some more. We got into in the last episode, we got in and we made this sword, our stone pick. I made this hatchet just from the bronze axe head and a bone stick, or a bone rod. Yeah, but today we're going to replace the tool station here. I've gathered all the materials we need for it. So if I go into tool, the tool forge. We need 4 iron blocks, the tool station, and the 3 seared bricks. And this is basically an upgraded version. Oh, 2, 3. 3 there. I made the iron blocks here. And then we have the tool forge, so if we just go into crafting, shift, left click, or right click, or whatever, we get the tool forge. So, we're going to put this right here. Or, actually, I think we're going to move this stuff because I want to dig over that way. But we're also going to replace this sign. Or, not. I don't really need to do that. But, as you can see now, we have a lot more options on making stuff. We're going to make a hammer. Great for mining and stuff, and we're also going to upgrade our tools, like this pick here. We're going to upgrade this. Maybe we might make a cleaver. That seems kind of cool. Or maybe just, not really. No, I think we'll just stick with this sword till it breaks. Yeah, so let's get it. Oh yeah, when you make seared bricks, you make the mighty smelting book. So, we're going to get to take out this one. No, we don't need that one. This one just. So, hammer. We need a hammerhead, 2 large plates, and a tough rod. So, we already have a stone large plate. We can't make iron. Actually, stone is really actually the best we can make at the moment, because we another thing we need to make is, I believe it's called a smeltery, for all metals, basically. So, do I have everything I need? Large plate pattern, tough tool rod. We need one more pattern. Luckily, we can use Oh, I also got some rubber too. And I got some kind of cool wood that I want to use to build. Actually, no, I don't want to use this wood. I'm saving that for something else. It makes a pretty awesome or cool looking wood here. Oh. One of those and two. Oh wait, no. We already have all the materials. Okay. Blank pattern. Stencil table. Oh, you can't shift click. Oh, and also I updated my Feed the Beast launch ultimate. It's not the recommended one yet, but the time being, it's wait, I okay, I don't need this, but I can still just write Oh, okay, well, we need another stencil then. I thought you could change it, but I guess you can't. Yeah. So now I have the updated version of Applied Energistics, which I really want to get into because of the quantum tunnel, I believe it's called. It's very expensive thing, so we won't get into it for a long time. But when we get the materials and stuff, I want to get into that. Okay, now part builder. Put this in here. It takes 8 cobblestone to make a stone hammerhead. You're also going to need another large plate. 8 again. And then a tough tool rod pattern is there. So take that back and back. And if we go into our tool forge now and here. Oh, let's see. Right. I just want to see what I. Then that one I can't shift click in, but hammer. Stonebound, mining speed, 8-4. So we're going to improve this. This is quite basic. Oh, and it is just great on zombies, too. Okay, now we're going to go into the anvil and we're going to modify this. Put this in here. So. Start by taking a diamond. We're going to put this diamond here. It moves the mining level up to obsidian. The durability increases a lot. The mining speed stays the same, but now it has durability plus 500. Put it in again, and let's look at what we can use for modifiers. Emerald, I think I may want to use that. Redstone. Think we'll also add some redstone. Lapis. Now. No lapis. Okay, so going to take redstone. And an emerald. Emerald. Okay. I am going to also put these into blocks. It makes it quicker. This should increase the mining speed. So as you can see, increased, and now has s much is much faster at mining. Finally, I guess I'm going to add, I'm gonna add this emerald to it, which will increase the durability by 50%. So if you're going to add a diamond and an emerald, you may want to add the diamond first, because then when you add the emerald, you get more, because this adds 50%, so, yeah, just, okay, there. Now, I want to go down in the mines here, and just show you why I wanted this tool. Okay, I'll show you here. Mine's a 3x3. So that makes mining a lot easier. I'll just show you down in the caves here. I've done a lot of work, a lot of mining, a lot of light lit up places, and just going to art going down. I know there's a zombie around here somewhere, and eventually he's just going to sneak right up on us. So I want to dig down to just to level 12. I know there's iron there, but I don't really care that much about iron right at the moment. You know what? I actually don't have any torches. So, oh wait, actually, there's coal right here. I'll just dig right back up here. Oh wait, no. This point is actually going to be quite boring, so when I get down to level 12, I'll meet you back up there. We've still got some more stuff I want to do, so I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. I did a lot of mining, just a little mining. Of course, I ran out of room, so I had to stop earlier than I wanted. But I got a lot more stuff. Not really that much. I got another emerald, though. So that's the plus side. Let's see here. Uranium. I'll put ore berries in there. Redstone, sulfur, quartz, and coal. Okay, well, we are going to need to move these now. So actually, for this, instead of having to take all this stuff out, something I think I have a little bit better of an idea. Hey, what the? Oh, there's missing textures. Okay, there we go. Force wrench. Force ingot, force gear. All this is stone gear and force ingots. Let's, seven. And for, okay. What? What's with all the lag? I was, there's less. Okay, there's something above my house, above the my building that's causing me lag. I don't like it. You know, I'm gonna try to resolve this, and I'll be right. Okay. I'm not sure if that really helped at all. Doesn't look like it, but I did kill a creeper and a skeleton. So yeah. Hey, so let's see. If two iron, so just gonna make 2, 3, 4, 4, then 1, 2, 3, 4, just need 8 there, and in here do this, 4 ingots. Now we need a gear. Oh, by the way, this lag hopefully won't go on. Well, eventually will stop when I'm playing Minecraft, because I am planning on getting a new computer, and it's a much better computer than mine. It does, so I'm hoping that will resolve the lag a little, or a lot. I mean, not a little, because if it was a little, I'd just be fine with this. Okay, so we got ourselves a force wrench. We'll leave if we take this and shift right click. We get a pattern chest. Pattern chest back. But it does look weird, so if this put it down, all his inventory stays in. Is there anything in there? No. So, now what? I'm gonna dig out space for the forge, or the whatever it's called. Because I'd like to be able to get some iron tools, maybe. So, when I have a big enough area cleared out, we'll go on with making the stuff we need. So, I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. I dig out a pretty big area. Yeah, it's a nice expansion to my base. And we are going to begin making this. First of all, we need, there is the base. Now I think this is going to be enough. I'm also gonna take out these, put this away, and get this. So we need a smeltery controller. So it's just 8 of those. Yeah, I think we're going to need more. But if we do, I'll get more. Did I just put the book away? Oh, it's from my. Okay, next, we need a smeltery drain. I want 2 of those. We're also going to need a lava seared tank. So, we are going to get some glass that I've had kind of cooking up. Just gonna put 1 in there. There, and boom. Now we can melt stuff, but we still need a way to where you take it out. So I'm going to, well, actually, first, I am want to gather some lava, and a quick and easy way I know how, so happens to use this force wrench. So we're gonna go back down in the mines, because I did find some lava while I was down there. Oh, I can't up in this. Yeah, we're going to need a lot of quartz, because I will want to start doing applied energistics, essentially. Okay, you know what? It's bothering me too much. I gotta take the iron. We will, of course, need it for when we want to make iron tools, but I saw that one. I'm just trying to, oh, it's a little higher than I thought it was. Okay, good. No, I want the cobble. Oh, no, no. Damn water. I actually think, though, I know we're not going to get the obsidian, but just want to try this out. Okay, so I'm going to put down this tank and this tank. And basically what I am going to do is grab lava, put in the tank. Grab lava, put in the tank. Grab lava, put in the tank. Now I'm going to try to fill both these tanks and get some more grout. And the rest of the materials we need. And I'll just show you what those materials are. I want two drains. I don't need seared glass, but seared faucets. We need two of those per drain. One per drain. I want a casting table and a casting basin. And that's all we need, so I'm going to get all that stuff, and then I'll meet you back upstairs. Hey guys, I died. That's why I had to keep inventory on. I was about 500 blocks. I found a great wood tree. I'm going to waypoint this. Sorry, wrong button is, great wood. One. I don't want to see this in the nether. But it also happened to have a spider spawner in it. Which I am since I have the force wrench, I'm just going to dump a bunch of junk in here. Because I guess this is kind of a cheat, but hey, it's in the game. So I don't really have the inventory. Now there's a lot more things I'd much rather prefer to see in there, but, hey, I found a chest, I guess it's pretty good. So I'm gonna, again, get the materials and stuff, and I have the clay. I probably have sand, but I'll just get a little bit more sand, so I'll meet you back later, when I get there. Okay, I'm back. I put this lava tank down here, and I put some lava. I I did not mean to do that. I put some lava in here, because it needs lava to run. Now, we are going to finish setting this up. We are going to make this one... Oh, alright. You can't stand in it when it's active. It hurts. So we're going to make this one higher. We're going to put the drain here. Another drain here. Seared faucets. Casting basin. Casting table. Finally. Now, if we open up this, we got a lot of stuff in here. Now, first thing... Actually, we're going to sleep. Now, okay, let's just camp. Now, it works basically like a, works like a furnace, a pulverizer. So, we're actually going to need some copper and aluminum, and we're going to put, time being, we're just going to put one aluminum, one copper. As you can see in there, it's working. These are going, they are in there, and it is smelting. Now, you don't want to put them in there yourself, it won't work. You got to put them in here. It's going to smelt, and we're going to get some form of alloy, but in liquid form. Now, I'll hold on for that. Between this next episode, I'm gonna make this look nicer, get rid of this dirt and stuff. I'm gonna make this my Tinker's Construct room. Yeah. It looks like that's all finished up, so I'll just take that. I'm also gonna smelt this stuff, but what I'm gonna do now is I wanna make some what I need to make better tools. Like actual metal tools. So for that we're going to need some of these like this stuff. So let's see. We're gonna make a stone binding. Take a tool rod, and we don't. So, I think that will work. If we look in here, okay, there's now, and we look in here, it's molten copper and molten aluminum brass. So, yeah, we wanted aluminum brass. I'm not sure if that will be enough, but if it's not, put in some more. So now we put this piece here. And we're going to pour the aluminum brass in there. We got a tool binding cast. I'll take this out and I'll put this in. Okay, yeah, it's not enough. So, more aluminum ore in there. Also, I want to make an ingot cast. Because if you make a block, the only way to get aluminum ingots from Tinker's Construct anyway once is from an ingot cast. If you put it into blocks, you're gonna get raw aluminum ore. If you just smelt it right away from in a furnace, you're gonna get raw aluminum ore. Let's see, there's 6 nuggets of copper. So now if we finish this off, it's how much aluminum brass. So we're going to put in 2 of those. I also want to we're going to need to put this stuff down, actually. So, part builder. Wrong thing. Part builder in here. And we'll get some cobblestone. for the time being, I'm just going to put them right there and there. Get my carrots out because I'm hungry. Okay, so I'm going to take a pickaxe. Stone pickaxe head. Okay. We are going to put in the pickaxe head. Okay. Now if we just pour that over here. Pickaxe head. I am, however, though, also just going to take one ingot. Oh, no, that's not what I wanted to do. Just pour it over this. Okay, we got ourselves an ingot cast. I'm going just to work on this, I'm just going to be doing this, until next time, please like and subscribe, I'll see you later, goodbye.